potential tornado. I don't know if the tornado is still confirmed on the ground. I haven't seen that confirmation. It was earlier, so we're going to call this a tornado that's moving off to the east. It's going to be doing some damage in these neighborhoods. Debris signature is still showing up on radar, so we're calling this a tornado. It's doing damage. I emphasize just how serious of a situation this is. Okay? This has done damage in the Preston Hollow area. It's been a confirmed tornado, and it's moving through these areas as we speak. Get in your safe spot immediately. This is doing damage. County and Southern Dallas County, where our second tornado, it's like a third tornado warning now, our other tornado warned storm is moving toward Red Oak. If you live in Red Oak, you live toward Lancaster or Ferris, make sure you're seeking shelter immediately because this thunderstorm is moving in your direction. And there has been confirmed damage on the north side of Midlothian. You live in these areas, this is about how much time you have to get prepared. Okay, so it'll be in the Sachse area here around 9:35. It'll be in Murphy around 9:38, Wiley at 9:46, Lavon 9:57, St. Paul at 9:47, and Millwood around 9:56. This thunderstorm has had a history of doing damage.
So here we are now. Look, check this out. We are without electricity now. We don't know what's going on. We know two tornadoes hit Dallas, and the last I seen when the TV went off was that there was a tornado near us. Possibly, they had not confirmed it, near Terrell along Interstate 20. They seen the hook, but they had not confirmed the rotation, and that's what I was waiting to hear when the power went down here. We're seeing all the footage come in of buildings collapsed, power lines down, homes damaged, cars turned over, big trucks flipped over, SUVs, just so much. super strong winds, and then it just stopped. Melinda got a alert on her phone that says a tornado possible in the Terrell area, but we don't have any idea to know where. But I do, man, that lightning is crazy straight above us. Look at that. This is just the first wave. We got one more wave of this. They said it's coming after this one. And it's gonna have hard straight line winds. Lightning is just like non-stop. Did you find anything on your phone, Mo? Just general weather. Well, guys, we're still without power, but we're okay. We didn't get hit by a tornado. We don't know why our power is out, but we were scared. And the TV's on, and you're like, if you're without power, why is your TV on? It's because I have an inverter going off batteries outside and extension cords running across the floor everywhere. Yeah. So all they're talking about is
this neighborhood though was hit pretty hard, and we are actually not far away from President George W. Bush and his wife Laura. They live around here, but a spokesman tells CBS News they are fine. They're more concerned with their neighbors and hope everyone is doing better.
Well, here we are. It's another day. It's a sunny, pretty day, but we're without power still. But we didn't get hit by the tornado, but we were right at the edge of it. We had a storm just south of us, and we had a storm just north of us, and we were caught in between. We did get strong winds and hail, and we've been without power since last night. And I had my TV going. I'm watching YouTube. It's first we've seen any of it. So I got my big inverter out again. It's a true 3,000 watt. Got two deep cycle batteries here jumped together, and it's putting out power, and to keep those batteries charged right now, just an emergency. We got a spare car sitting here that I've got sitting here just running. It need to run anyway, because it's been sitting. Keep the fresh gas burn through it. And so we're doing just fine with that. I've got one cord going and keeping the refrigerator and all that going there, and I got another one that's going to our TV and to our internet router and to our internet service up on the roof. So we're back in touch with the world. Our stuff's staying cold, so we're just fine. And man, that Dallas took a lot of damage. I figured that's why the power companies are all there helping the people that really need it. We're okay, but I don't blame Encore or power company. If their focus is to help those people, I can do without power. I don't care if it takes a few days. I'll sacrifice and not whine and complain to see all these people that really need help get it. But we're watching the TV right now, and it's pretty bad. It looks like it destroyed a whole Home Depot too. Buildings collapsed, cars flipped, houses destroyed, power lines ripped out. It went right through a heavy populated part of the city.